Hi there, my name is Brett Armstrong. I'm from Wild Coast Kayaks down in East London in the Eastern Cape, South Africa. And today I want to talk to you about a fantastic new product that we've just finished setting up. It's the Fluid Chumani Kayak, which sitting at 3.29 meters, and it's got a capacity of 130 kilograms. And it only weighs 22 kilograms the way it comes from the factory. And made here in South Africa, proudly South African. And an awesome kayak. We've got a beautiful white one, which is very, very rare. So I was really grateful to the factory for sending me this white one. And just to go through some of the basic features that we've fitted and some more advanced features. And you'll see we've done a host of different modifications, all to make your time on the water more enjoyable, more organized. There's nothing worse than being on the kayak, fishing in the ocean. Rough conditions or not, you need to be organized. If you're not organized and properly laid out, your time on the water will not be as enjoyable as you hope. And why do we go on the water? We go on the water to have a good time and obviously to catch some fish and maybe release some as well. So we'll go through the modifications one at a time and then you can see what we've done to this awesome little kayak. Okay, so starting from the front of the kayak, just to make things easier, what we've done is we've placed another drain plug. It's not really needed, but I just like to always like to drain the kayak after cleaning it from the front. It's just easier the way I like it. So it's just a small little modification there. When we move down, we've kept the standard bungee cords. Obviously they're there. It's really great to have them here because you can always stash your life jacket under here while you're just getting to the beach or whatever it is. But as well as we've placed this hydroturf matting, this non-slip matting, which other than protecting the actual kayak when you put the paddle and just to park the paddle while you're out there, it just gives a nice sleek look and obviously it protects the plastic from getting damaged. Okay, this is quite a big modification we've done. With our Lowrance fish finder, we don't run the standard conventional batteries that most guys use for gate motors or alarm motors. Instead we've run the Nokwa 10 amp battery. It's a lithium based battery, and to top it all off, we've added this waterproof hatch in the front. It's a 4-inch hatch. So we drill the hole, place the 4-inch hatch, which fits the battery. A lovely little battery which lasts ages for sure out on the water, multiple trips out there. Secondly, we've got these little loops. It's just for when you're negotiating a bit of the surf moving from one spot to another. We just put the rod tip through there. The rod sits perfectly nice there if you don't want it sitting in the back in the rod holders that we've installed. Another awesome little modification, rail blazer. The rail blazer comes up with an amazing range of products. On the wall here we've got rod holders, camera mounts, camera holders, all sorts of convenient little goodies, but they really are amazing. They're super strong, awesome quality. And we've got this little camera mount with a base, starboard base. And this moves in all different directions, up and down. We've got an extension pole that also raises it up. But a really awesome thing. And we've got a little saddle on the side here, just with a little leash, just in case we take a tumble in the surf and we don't want to make sure we don't lose it. And of course, the actual Lowrance fish finder, which we'll get to a little bit later. All right, on the sides here, we've got a mesh pocket on each side. It's just awesome to keep your tools in there while you're out there or even when you're launching. Put your lip grip there and your maybe your pliers and your knife on this side. Awesome stuff. And of course here we've got a water bottle holder, or just a holder for a tool that comes standard, as most of you have seen. And then we've put a couple of extra saddles here as well, just to, you know, just to secure those tools so that when you are out in the water you don't want to lose that, drop it over the side and there goes your lip grips or your pliers or whatever it is, and that will spoil the day for sure. We've stuck with the standard 6-inch hatch that Fluid puts in at the factory here. And it's got a lovely little little mesh pocket, a nice little inserted bag. We've also, just to make things a bit easier for us as well, we've put two little bungee cord leashes which wrap around the internal side of the scupper holes. It's just to maybe you want to secure some stuff that's inside the hatch, little things like maybe just some bait or whatever that you've got in a separate bag. It works perfectly. Simple thing, little fitting, bit of bungee cord, and it saves you trying to dig for stuff further down, which can certainly be quite frustrating. The handles on the Chumani are super strong. They are really awesome plastic, high quality stuff. These little fittings, they're all standard, just like these in the front with the bungees. So those are really good. If we move further back, this is where it really becomes a little bit more involved that we've done. All right, when you look at the back of the Chumani, it comes standard with an 8-inch hatch. I like the 6-inch hatch in the front. It's got an inserted bag, which is quite handy. You can put your stuff in there, some food, some tackle, whatever it is. And you've got quite a big capsule underneath here, which obviously flows all the way through to the front. So really great area to work with. But we decided to get a little bit more interesting and a little bit more clever. And we put an additional 8-inch hatch. The platform at the back here is pretty level at certain parts, so we managed to get an 8-inch hatch to fit here absolutely perfectly with obviously all the fittings and all that stuff. You should put silicone in and before you drill the screws, just to ensure that you get no water leaking in. But the hatches generally dry and keep dry most of the time, so it's pretty good depending on your conditions. And a great area here. Effectively, I will sit here and I will feed my rods in from this side, sitting sideways. My rods fit perfectly into here, down the hatch, and once again, clever little thing these. This stops your rods and your other goodies going all the way to the front and spoiling your day. There's nothing worse than not being able to reach your rod, and you go in the ocean to fish, and if you can't reach your rod, you're not going to have a good day. So these just clip onto the rods and they just lie 1, 2, 3 or however many you have, and they're just there. In the back here we've got three little saddles. It's just multi-purpose little features there for you to hook whatever. Maybe you have something at the back, a bag or whatever else. But on the other side of this is actually an additional saddle which the bungee is actually connected to. So it's just keeping it perfectly secure with an additional saddle underneath. Some say it's an overkill. For me it's just being really organized, and that's what I like to be. But this area in the back is actually really, really big, and I'm sure with the additions that are going to follow one of these days, I think we're going to optimize this space in a much, much better way. But certainly that's making the most of it while we're there. Of course, the two standard rod holders, we've kept them in the same place with an additional third one there. Some guys have opted to put an additional one over here instead of an 8-inch hatch. It's the first time I've seen an 8-inch hatch in the back here. Some guys put an additional fishing rod holder here and they don't have anything here. That's also an option if you're on the river. It might be a great, great opportunity there. But on the other end, we look over here and we've got this little piece of bungee here, and this works exceptionally well. That's actually a paddle park, so you do that, put your paddle in there, and then you just clip it over and it keeps your paddle perfectly next to the craft while you're fishing. Right, just on this side of the kayak now that we moved it around, two very, very simple but very, very important and effective little bits of accessories. So on this side here, your paddle leash. Really, really important. When kayaking in the ocean, you cannot launch without a good quality paddle leash. This is your lifeline between you and the kayak, and a must for launching. And for certainly for coming in, and while you're out there, for sure you need to keep this on your paddle. It's nothing more dangerous than being stuck out in the middle of the ocean without a paddle. So this is your lifeline. Then this other little goodie here, it's a very, very simple but effective system. Basically, we've got a piece of rope that's tied from the front along the way to a little carabiner hook. And the idea with this is twofold. One, it's an initial part of a tow rope. Should you lose your paddle, or should you be in a really unsafe situation and you need to just hook onto somebody, it's just a very simple 8mm rope, and it really does the job. Or alternatively, this can be the start of your anchoring process. So you have an additional anchor with anchor rope, with a bungee cord and all the rest of it. And it just clips onto this, goes to the front, and then you let your anchor rope out, and then when you're ready to bring it up, you paddle a bit forward. This will come with a little floating mechanism that's on the anchor rope. Unclip it, put it there, pull the anchor up, and you're away for it. So just a simple little modification. Of course, you get much more complex anchor systems and anchor trolley systems, which we also do. But for the purpose of this kayak, we just thought we'd do one of the more simple but effective little goodies. that certainly make it a bit easier when you're on the water and you want to anchor just in 10 meters or 20 meters of water. It's pretty simple. When you're starting to anchor 40 meters of water, you need a much more secure and stronger means, because the currents are obviously more at that depth. Okay, lastly but certainly not the least, the fish finder. So for sure, for us, for our applications, I believe that Lowrance has got the best product range in all of the different brands that are out there available at the moment. This particular unit, it's called the Hook 5. It's actually the predecessor for the new Hook 2 5 unit. We are happy with this unit. Of course, it's a fantastic unit that they had already launched some time back. And we had it and we just put it on this for my demoing purposes. And an awesome unit, very, very powerful. Got multiple functions that are more than adequate for even a ski boat, let alone a jet ski or a kayak. And as I mentioned earlier, in the front, we are running the Nokwa lithium battery model, which is a 10 amp. And it sits in the front, feeds power directly in there. It's absolutely brilliant. I can go out for at least about 20 hours on that battery, depending on how I'm using the fish finder. But certainly a very powerful little unit. For me, if you were going to look at buying this little kayak, very, very effective kayak. Surfing the waves, launching, absolutely brilliant. The keel design, there's no rudder, it's just got two skegs. And absolutely brilliant the way it just carves through the waves, carves coming in, it just pops over the waves, it's really good. The nose design, at first you may think it's a bit deceiving that it looks like it could be quite affected by wind, but in actual fact, underneath the nose, it does have a very good V section, just like the Bumba, its big brother, and it's really, really effective. So it's, it cuts through the water very nice, tracks exceptionally well, even in big crosswinds, so that's really, really important. I think in general, this kayak at 3.3 meters basically, 22 kilograms. You can't get a kayak that weighs 22 kgs that you can go in the ocean. This is absolutely brilliant. All you need if you're fishing off the bottom or just fishing some live bait other side of the waves and want to catch some tuna or whatever it is you're fishing, some great bottom fish, nothing beats this. Alright, so just to finish off, thanks very much for listening, guys, and yeah, this is an amazing kayak, like I said, and very, very big thank you to Fluid Kayaks and of course to Lowrance for all the awesome support that they give us over the years. And looking forward to amazing stuff from this kayak and the future mods that we're going to be doing, certain adjustments to the molds. I think this kayak is really going to start turning heads. So please follow us on Facebook. We are also there as Wild Coast Kayaks, of course. And www.wildcoastkayaks.co.za is our website. And we look forward to hearing from you in the future. Thanks a lot. Tight lines, go safe.